In the honesty of Kay's confession, she said there was times. There were those places in her heart that she had to come and bring it back to the cross again and again and again. And the beauty and the truth is that we can come to the cross again and again and again. We can come to the cross at any time. And when we come to the cross and we come to Jesus, how do we know? How do we know that the forgiveness is real? How do we know that God takes it serious? We have this wonderful promise from His Word. It's found in 1 Colossians. Colossians chapter 1, verses 19. It says, "For in Him all the fullness of God was pleased to dwell, and through Him to reconcile to Himself all things, whether on earth or in heaven, making peace by the blood of the cross. And you, who were once alienated and hostile in mind, doing evil deeds, He has now reconciled in His body of flesh by His death, in order to present you holy and blameless and above reproach before Him." The Bible teaches us in the body of Jesus, in the physical body of Jesus Christ, God dwelt, and in Jesus, He reconciled everything in heaven and on earth. In the body of Jesus, He brought peace. He brought forgiveness. He took away everything that would separate us from Him and from one another, that we may stand holy and blameless before Him. And so tonight, we come to the cross. We come to the body of Jesus. We come to the table of the Lord. We come to the place where God has chosen to reconcile heaven and earth, all of us with each other. We come to the table of the Lord. For on the night that Jesus was betrayed, He took the bread. And when He had given thanks and broken it, He said, "This is My body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of Me." And in the same way, He also took the cup. After supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in My blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of Me. For as often as you eat this bread and you drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until He comes." So tonight we're going to come to the table of the Lord. It is available to all of us who have put our faith in Him. And we partake of His body, which was the place of reconciliation. And we partake of His blood, which is the cleansing, the new covenant, the new life in Him. And we celebrate the life that He's given us, that we all may stand holy, blameless, without reproach before Him. And whatever it is that you're struggling with, whoever it is that you're struggling tonight, come to the table of the Lord. Come to the body of Christ, where we find peace, reconciliation, wholeness, and forgiveness in Jesus' name. So tonight as we worship, there are tables in the front, on the left, on the right. There are tables in the back, on the left and the right. No one's going to serve you. You get to go to the table at your own time, at your own pace, and take the bread and take the cup. You may want to go back to your seat and continue to worship. You may just want to take worship right there and take communion with the Lord right there. But do this in remembrance of what Jesus has done for you. And let Him bring His life in a tangible, experiential way. May we receive and become what He has given for us to become. Tonight, we have those that will be coming, and they'll be standing in front here. If you have something that you want to have prayed about, we have people who have come just tonight just to pray for you. Maybe you want to pray about someone that you just really need help in releasing, letting go and forgiving. Maybe it's something else. But we're here to pray for you. We're going to worship. We want you just to come into the presence of the Lord at your own pace, in your own way. But let's worship the Lord together in Jesus' name.